Hello there everyone and welcome to this video. Today I've got 7 tips for you on how to improve your renders and how to make them more interesting in general. Number 1 is an HDRI. By default, Blender will start off with a very solid gray background. It can look very dull. So we're going to change it to an HDRI, so you can download one for free on polyhaven.com. Head over to the HDRI section and you can download any of them in any quality. I usually go for 4K, which works fine. An HDRI is basically a 360 degree image that also contains some lighting information. Alright, so you will both get reflections in your scene and lighting as well. And that will add a lot of realism right off the bat. A nice thing to do when you're playing around with the HDRI with the rotation is to set the surface settings, the sampling, to manual. Okay, and when you set it to manual, it's gonna be at 1024 by default. And that's just gonna make it rotate quicker and update in your camera, in your scene quicker as well, so you can really see what the rotation changes in your scene. The second thing we're gonna do is adding some depth to our scene. And there is a little trick that a lot of artists use to get a little bit more of depth and a little bit more interesting stuff in the scene. And it is reflections, okay? By default, a lot of ground surfaces, they are gonna be very rough, very flat, bumpy. And that means there are not gonna be a lot of reflections in your scene. But if you add some puddles there, they will actually reflect your scene and they will just make it look a little bit bigger, like there's more depth in your scene as well, and those reflections always look nice. So there's a very easy way to do that. We can do it by adding a noise texture to our ground material. That's going to be defining where our puddles are actually going to be. All right, the black parts are going to be a low roughness, those are going to be puddles. And everything that's white in that texture, that's gonna be a higher roughness, right? And we can also connect that to the normal map to remove the normals from that area, okay? Because where there is a puddle, you will not really see the texture or the normals of the ground underneath it. It's going to be smooth like water, like glass. The same thing we can do with the displacement, of course. If there's a displacement map in your texture, then we can just connect it there as well, and it will give us the same results as for the normals, pretty much. Right, and then it's just tweaking the settings and placing the texture, the noise texture, wherever you want it to be, changing the scale, the size, and tweaking some of the other settings to your own liking as well. Right, so the real thing we want to achieve here is to just add more space, more depth in our scene. The same reason why people add mirrors in an elevator is because it can feel very cramped. Right, so if you have a small area like this, for example, where it's covered with houses and there's a bus coming in, it's nice to have a little bit of an escape perhaps. And well, there's a very nice way to do it is with adding some puddles on the ground, because it's a natural thing if it rains, of course, right? So it also adds a little bit of a mood in the scene as well. But I ended up with the node setup for the material of the ground. You can just copy this or create your own one. Anyhow, it will look very nice and it will add that extra layer of space in your scene. Number 3 is lights. Lights are incredibly important to your scene and it is nice to have a backstory behind your lighting, right? What's happening? Why is it the way it is, right? It is very weird just placing random lights in your scene without there being any reason of a light being there, all right? So imagine having lamps in your scene. That is a nice source for a light. For example, right here we've got the bus that has lights coming from the front, so that's going to be shining in front of the bus as well, right? So those are just little storytelling elements in your scene that can really push it to that next level. Just match the light source, set it to a spot, an area light, whatever you need for your scene, and match the direction that you will have in real life as well. So for this bus, it's going to be pointing forwards and a little bit down so it doesn't shine in the people's eyes that are coming at you from the other side. Ambience and mood, volumetrics. It is an important factor in your scene, at least when you want to create a little bit of a moody vibe, which is something I personally really like, right? We get a little bit of a foggy look and the lights have something to actually pass through, right? Because you will have some density there. So we can just add a very easy cube in our scene, make it bigger than our scene, and just give it a little bit of density for that light to shine through. And you will see it interacting very nicely with the HDRI as well. Right, so just tweak those settings a little bit. Start off with a low density, and then that is going to be a very nice starting point for the scene. I'm decreasing the color management, the exposure a little bit here because it was very bright. And those settings are just something you will keep tweaking throughout the entire scene. Same for the HDRI, by the way. The rotation, the stuff like that, is something you will keep tweaking until the end. Right, then I'm just going to tweak some final lights after we added that volume, added the density. And now you will see me changing the spotlight, sorry, the point light in those lampposts to an actual spot here. Just to add some nicer lighting, right? Those point lights were lighting up the entire scene, and I just want them to be directed downwards a little bit more and more specific direction. More mood, more ambience, and more vibe is what I want in my scene. So I'm adding something that adds a lot of depth in there, something that adds a little bit of a story as well, right? And that is a little bit of dust particles, a little bit of particles floating in the air close to the camera and far away from the camera as well. And that's gonna work very nicely together with a little bit of depth of field as well. To get that started, we're gonna add a cube there and stretch it up a little bit in the Y direction, make it bigger, cover the parts where you want them to be, and we're just gonna add a particle system as an emitter, and we're just gonna play it for a second, add the number, increase the number, add an icosphere with the lowest subdivisions, that's gonna be a particle, and then we're gonna set the render object to that icosphere and just reduce the scale and add some randomness. Those are gonna be our particles right here, right? Add the number a little bit, add some more, and emit them from the volume instead of faces. That's important as well. Turn off the gravity because we want them to be floating calmly, right? They're going to be very fast, so just reduce that initial normal velocity so they're going to be small. Set the gravity entirely to zero, and they're going to be moving nicely. Add a little bit of a turbulence force field there, decrease the strength, and there we go. They're nice and slow, and just go back to your particles and increase the lifetime so they're going to be around for a little bit longer. Just scale that up, cover your scene, and there we go. We got some nice slow moving particles. Now in a rendered view, it is going to look like a very regular particle. So we're going to change the scale a little bit to be smaller, and there we go. Now a final thing we can do is just tweak those settings, add a material, add some transmission, and remember not to add it to the cube, but to the actual icosphere. Add some transmission, increase the roughness, and we're gonna also just make it a little bit more transmissive and reduce the alpha so it looks like the light is partly shining through. Then just set the color you want for your scene, and then the depth of field. That's going to be very, very nice because it's going to add depth in our scene, right? So the foreground, we want it to be a little bit blurred. We want the focus object to be that bus, right? It's coming from the right and it's interacting with the people a little bit. So that's going to be the focus point. So just enable depth of field and set the bus to be your focus object or anything that is in front of the bus. And then just set the f-stop to be what you want it to be. Higher f-stop will mean a less depth, and a lower f-stop is basically going to increase the depth in your scene, so increase the blurriness that is going to be further away from your focus object. Right, in the end it can still feel like something is missing from your scene, and in my case it was a little bit of a light coming from in front of the camera, right behind the camera, and in this case it's very nice because we're on a road, alright, so there's a car driving in front of the bus and it's braking, so the brake lights are red and shining back onto the bus, onto the character on the sidewalk, and onto the road as well, also lighting up some of these front particles. So that's just going to add some vibe to the scene and a little bit of a storytelling as well, right? You can tell that there is something there that shines back in a red light on a road. Come on guys, it has to be a car. Right, then once you're done, once you're satisfied with what you've done right now, you can always revise any of the steps we had before, add more lights, remove lights, tweak the volumetrics, anything you really want, tweak the particle system, and that's going to be that, right? So then the final results is gonna look something like this, and compared to this, this is much better, has my preference. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope you learned something at how you can add, for example, a little bit of a mood, an ambience, a nice vibe to your scene by just adding a few objects, tweaking a few settings, and just getting that scene story in there a little bit more. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.